solar PVTV once again from RES4AFRICA event in Nairobi in Kenya. So we speak to Sergio Mercuri from the Italian ministry, but also working for different organizations.
The role I perform at the moment is co-chairing from the Italian side the EU-Africa partnership, the European-African Energy Partnership, and more regularly working as a sustainability coordinator at the Ministry of Foreign Affairs in Italy. The event is a very important event because it takes place for the first time in Africa and brings here the discussion about the importance of the renewables. The renewables are not just a way of getting energy, but are the way for getting clean energy. And this contributes to the major goal of the energy objective in the Sustainable Development Goals of the United Nations.
And what is the role, let's say, within these activities of Italy?
Italy, of course, has been among the countries who take part of the decision to adopt the 16 development goals last year in New York, wanted to see made this objective, obtaining not just the access to Africa, of Africa to energy, a sustainable future for the continent, but see, if possible, the involvement of entities who have the capacity to carry out this gesture.
So you are co-chairing this organization, so could you tell us more about, you know, how it's structured? Is it NGO or government-driven? And what are your activities and also the plan?
The two major engines of the organizations are the European Commission and the African Union Commission. From the European side, Germany and Italy are performing the role of High President. From the African side, COMESA and Egypt. The role of the co-president, of the co-chair, is to stimulate and sometimes perform special activities such as the stakeholder forum we held in Milan last May. But in general, the expertise matured by this organization in 10 years of activity is very important. The network of persons in Africa and in Europe involved in this area, and not just in the government, but also in the private sector, in academia, is the real added value of the AAP. AAP is in touch with the European Commission and the African Union Commission, and in both cases have access to the possibility to stimulate the use of development programs. This is another important area because the development programs are the catalyst of activities for the private and for the public sector.
So last question, I think, because you work, let's say, for sustainability topics since quite a lot of years. So you were observing, you know, how this topic was developing in different countries, also the perseverance from the side of politicians, of the local people. So how would you describe this evolution in people's minds? And how do you think what should be still done across the African countries?
In all over the years, we have seen developing the perception of the importance of sustainability. But only after the adoption of the new Global Agenda 2030, we are now able to see a coherence and an external and internal coherence of this concept. It will take time for obtaining the adoption and implementation in each of the country of the United Nations, but now at least we have a scheme, we have a way to coordinate at the national level.
We have roadmap activity.
And this is a very important step forward. Energy is an area, but we can say the same about human rights, about fight to bribery. We have also problem in the area of environment, as you know. So sustainability is a concept. The adaptation of this concept, the transposition of this concept to the reality implies the work of government, but also the several stakeholders which are involved in this huge endeavor.
And clean energies and solar energy particularly can be one of the important tools, yes, in order to create the sustainable world.
The obvious observation is that energy affects all the remaining 16 goals because you need energy for everything, and the solar energy among the renewable energy is one of the options. We are striving for getting this for the continent which has already all the sources, all the possibility to utilize in the best conditions, which is of course Africa.
So I believe that you will be still supporting RES4AFRICA?
We will continue to support RES4AFRICA as well as any organization which assemble private and public capacities, academia, in order to project abroad our compliance to the Sustainable Development Goals.
Okay, thank you so much. That was Solar PVTV together with Sergio Mercuri, who is helping to build the sustainable world from the side of the Italian government, but also through the EU-Africa partnership. Thanks for watching.